Hi Scorpio, welcome to Miracle the Tribe. Guys, I'm bringing you your December 2018 reading. This is going to be for Scorpio, Sun, Moon and Rising. Let's see what's coming up for Scorpio, Sun, Moon and Rising. Guys, if there is disturbance in the voice or the volume, I don't know what to say, but I can't fix it and I've tried fixing it. Maybe it's fixed, maybe it's not, so bear with me. This is the first card coming out for you, which is the Hierophant, which is your opposite sign, Taurus. So either you're dealing with the Taurus or you're dealing with an institution, school, court, family, any sort of institution. You can be dealing with an institution and you want to either speak your mind about it or you want to make yourself heard in an institution. You feel that you have gathered some knowledge regarding something like a class or like about some structure or the system that you are engaged with. That was weird. I'm sorry. Oh God, you really want to speak. You really want to speak. Actually, you know, you remember one of those toys where you have to key the toy and then it makes noise afterwards, like you have to put a key and then you have to wind the clock, basically something of that nature. So this card also has the key and the thing that just made noise, if you were able to hear it. I have a toy which was gifted to me like when I was a kid, and I had keyed that toy like about 3 hours ago and I don't know why it went off right now. So yeah, that was very weird. And this card has a key on it. So I'm getting that maybe, like I said, you really want to speak your truth, or you want to speak about something that you know, or you have formed an idea about an institution, like you have your own opinion about marriage, what you consider marriage, why one should get married, or what is love, what is government, what is education system, that sort of message I'm getting that. Or then you have the Three of Pentacles as the bottom of the deck. So it can be related to work, it can be related to coming of people together, like some people are coming together to speak on a platform or to discuss their ideas. It can also mean that some people are just gathering in a presence of somebody who is like an authority. So it can be like you are standing in front of a judge or a teacher, or you are just making a presentation. Now what I see here is that there is some sort of authority as well that you are dealing with, which will probably give you marks, or probably it also feels like it's a society which will give you some marks on how you are working or what kind of work that you are doing. So that's the message that I'm getting you. Now let's see what's coming up for Scorpio for the month of December 2018. So this is the end of the year reading almost. So what's the message for Scorpio for the month of December 2018? Messages for Scorpio for the month of December 2018. It's a 10 card Celtic cross. Important messages coming in for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising for the month of December 2018. I guess we are ready now, so I'll cut the deck. First card out is the Eight of Swords, which is the heart of the matter. What's crossing you is Seven of Cups. What's grounding you is the Daughter of Swords. What's in your past is the Son of Cups. What's on your mind is again this card. So definitely this card is coming up again. So either a Taurus person is on your mind, or you are dealing with a authority, like I said, like maybe you will be dealing with a authority in December. So be mindful that I think you're thinking about taking someone to the court, or you're thinking about making something official, gaining approval of people, something of that nature. Then this is your future. You come up in this reading as the Four of Wands. In your surrounding, there is some sort of conflict going on. Your hopes and fears is the Five of Wands. So I'm getting that it's a very heavy month for you, Scorpio, and this is Five of Pentacles. Very, very, very heavy month for you. There is only one major arcana which is related to your opposite sign. So you are feeling it very, like you're finding it very difficult. You are out of your element. There is only one, two cups card, and both those cup card are not very nice. One is of about the illusion. So you might be feeling very under some illusion, like you might be deceiving yourself, or somebody else is trying to deceive you. What's your overall energy is the Six of Swords. So the messages that I'm getting here is that there is you come up as somebody stable, someone wanting to take things forward, someone wanting to commit to something. This doesn't have to be committing to a relationship. This can be related to something like making a commitment to yourself. This can be about making things stable at home for yourself or for the other people. But overall, when I look at this reading, I'm seeing a lot of conflict, a lot of second guessing yourself, feeling very stuck, feeling very distracted. I'm also getting feeling very alone and lonely. So for some of the Scorpios here, I'm getting that you, because this is the energy, overall energy, where you are trying to move away from the darkness towards light. By the way, below this card you have the Five of Cups. This was the only five which was not here in the spread. You have Five of Pentacles, Five of Wands, Five of Swords, and now Five of Cups is just below this card. So it's number five is a very difficult place to be in. In tarot, number five is a very in fact, this is also a five. The Hierophant, in fact, itself is a five. So being a number five, or getting a lot of fives, it means that you are in a very uncomfortable position. Like, you need to do something, you need to make a move, you need to say something, you need to break something, you need to move forward. But it's like you are so uncomfortable, like you cannot go back, and you can't even move forward. It's like you are stuck in between something. So this card is very relevant here, where in the center of this reading you're feeling very stuck. Let me see. Your hopes and fear is that you are fearing that there will be some conflict or some sort of competition that you will have to deal with. You feel that people will be having different ideas, or people will be speaking something against you, or there are different ideas floating basically in your surrounding. And in your environment, there is ego battle, or some sort of somebody is leaving somebody out, or there is some sort of bitterness that I'm seeing here. What's positive in this is that you come up as the very stable card, so you are very stable and grounded, and in future things will be stable. But before things can get stable, you will feel very much alone and left out, like you will leave out somebody, or somebody will leave you out. So it's very clear, like like I said, five is a very uncomfortable position, and then you have two six card, which is, one is about balancing things out, and the second is about moving away from a very uncomfortable position to a very comfortable position. So maybe in the month of January, when you will move into the month of January, you will surpass all these difficulties in your life where you are feeling stuck. This is a place where you feel you cannot do something. This is a place where you're feeling that I don't have any option. You feel like somebody trapped you in a box, and either they defined you a wrong way, they described you in a wrong way, or they did you something terrible, and you are not able to make your move. Okay, so that's what I'm getting here, that you are not able to communicate about something, or you were dealing with somebody who was very cutting with their words. This person is a little bit immature and very hasty. Like this person, either this can be you as well, okay? So this person is someone who is very eager to say their, you know, whatever that is there in their mouth. So they will just say something. It can be somebody at your home. There can be conflict at home. There is a lot of bickering going on. Now, in past, there was a offer that you had, like a love offer, or somebody just telling you something really sweet, but right now you feel stuck. This can be you very, very playful in the past, enjoying something warm, but now things are disturbed, and it's almost due to the fact that you are not able to see something clearly. You are confused about something, like in a way that there was something hidden from you. The Hierophant is also about taking guidance and taking inputs from other people, from an expert or a professional. So you might be gathering some expertise, or you are just going to a expert in order to solve something. It can be related to business, it can be related to your project, it can be related to a relationship, anything. In your surrounding, there is definitely somebody who wants to win a fight no matter what. This person can be at home, but I think you will find it hard to move away from this person, but eventually you will move out, or this person is definitely leaving. This person is leaving. So you will have to either decide that you are going to leave, or this person is definitely leaving, because like I said, 555, it's a very uncomfortable position. You have to do something. Okay, so this is the card that I'm getting in your surrounding, which is Seven of Swords. So somebody around you is cheating. It can be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising. Cheating, deception, lies, and someone hiding information, someone manipulative, someone... Okay, so I'm saying all these things, but always be mindful, Scorpio, that whatever you see in the other person is sometimes a reflection of your own self. Like you have so many things that you might be hiding, but you feel like this person is hiding something. I'm not saying that you are hiding something. I'm just saying be sure if you're judging the person in a right way. Just go within to look for your answers. Don't just blame somebody, because you do come up as someone who is comfortable with things, but things around you are not comfortable. So yes, clear the confusion. Clear the confusion with by seeking facts, by seeking truth, by speaking truth, by asking right questions. Let me see. Yes, in future there is something which is coming down. In future there is something which is coming down, and after that thing comes down, there will be balance that will be restored. So you can be breaking a pattern, you can be breaking a habit, you will be breaking something. Either you will, basically this is actually you not breaking anything, it's universe breaking something. So universe will break something if you are not going to break it. Like you have to break something toxic that is in your life. If you are in a bad situation, you need to move out of it. Otherwise universe is going to make things difficult for you, and you will be either thrown out of the house, or you will be either, you know, something will happen to you. If you are not going to do something, something will happen to you, and then you will have to make that change. So you might not be feeling like I have to do something to improve my situation, because you are feeling you're lazy or something like that. But universe is not lazy, it will kick your butt, basically. So do it, like before it's too late, you do it. Don't stay stuck in this situation, asking yourself troublesome questions, asking yourself questions which are repetitive. Don't don't ask repetitive questions, why me, why not like that, why did this happen. Don't ask those questions and come out of this confusion that you are facing, because your crossing card is confusion. So there is some sort of confusion. Either you are focusing on the wrong thing, or you are getting inputs from 10 million people and they are all telling you different story. So do your own research. This card is also about doing your own research, and be very mindful of what you say. You are going to be a little bit cold, or you are fearing that you will be a bit cold when you will communicate your peace to someone. But you are quite happy. You are in your you are feeling a little bit emotional about something, especially related to home. You might be feeling a little bit emotional, but something at home is coming to an end, or your family is traveling, or you are traveling away from your family, or you are traveling to a new home or a new place. Someone is traveling here, or there is some sort of communication back and forth. Also, it can mean that there is something that is coming to a full closure at home. Like after a lot of movement, like for some time you were feeling stuck, but once you will start making your moves, something will come to a completion, like things will get completed. And Mother of Cups is telling me that then you will restore your comfort, your element. You will be expressing your emotions to amongst the people that you can trust. You don't have to be defensive. I'm also getting here that you are working two jobs, or you are trying to balance two things, definitely. And you're rushing, like hustle harder, like that sort of, you're hustling between two things. So the answer that I'm getting here is that you need to be very moderate. The word is moderate. Be moderate and balanced. So these two cards are coming side by side. Be moderate and balanced. One is about what you are giving. Are you giving too much? Are you receiving enough? And the other one is about being patient with the situation. Whatever is going on, slow or fast, be patient with it and take right moves with lot of coolness. Don't be in a hurry. This is somebody in lot of hurry. So don't just blurt things without any tactics. Be diplomatic is the message that I'm getting. Like I said, don't be defensive, and there can be a Taurus person or a water sign who is trying to defend themselves. So in past, somebody got a job opportunity. You might have got that job opportunity. Someone might have given you a promise of long lasting success or long lasting liberation or freedom. It was an opportunity for you to take. I don't know you took this opportunity or not, but there is something related to long lasting. The word is long lasting, and the word is success, prosperity, and the word is recognition or promotion. So there, all these things are in the past. Presently, you have to temper yourself, and in future you have to destroy something that is not serving you. And I'm also getting here that you are either scared about something which you know it is in your hand and you don't know how to make a move, or you have too much resources and you don't know how to apply it, where to apply it, what to do with those resources. So you are trying to get very clear about your ideas, how to implement those ideas. That's one of the messages that I'm getting. If you have a masculine figure in your life, it can be male or female, but if there is a masculine figure in your life, I'm getting that that person is trying to be that person is trying to make some rules, and you are being very defensive, or that person is being very defensive and that's why they are making a lot of rules. So you might be keeping your composure with this person, or it can be a institution, like I said, like you're trying to keep your composure with an institution, like your office, boss, anything. It can be a family member as well. Now, what I'm getting here again is when it comes to the male member of the family or a surrounding that you are dealing with, somebody is deceptive here, because their ego is in line. Like their ego is in line, so they are being sneaky. They are being. They can lie. They can deceive you. So be mindful of that. There is definitely deception, and you are feeling it. I know it because it was in your hopes and fear that there is something deceptive going on, and I think there is. So just be mindful of that and don't confront it directly. Try to be, like I said, try to be moderate and composed and be diplomatic. If there is a if somebody is leaving somebody out in the cold, they might be leaving because they are in some new love, or they will be rejecting new love. This can be you who is rejecting new love opportunity because you think you want more, or you are not recognizing there is a new love for you outside waiting for you. This can be a fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising. So you might miss this opportunity where somebody is offering you a Ace of Cups, but probably you do not want it, or this is you offering love to somebody and they are not wanting it because they feel that they want something else. But overall, what I feel here is that you are moving away from a situation that was not serving you, that was keeping you stuck, where you were probably weeping about something that has already happened in the past and it is not serving you anymore. And now you are deciding to move further by leaving this behind. You want to take a new path so that you can move from Five of Cups to Ten of Cups. So that was your reading, Scorpio. My readings are always all over the place. I try to keep it, you know, I try to make a story out of it, but I don't think that's fair, because so many people are going to watch this, and if I put a story out there like this is happening, that is happening, then that doesn't make sense, because we all are different, dealing with different things. So I just say the messages as they come. I don't try to make sense of them. Now let's see what's coming up for Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising. What is their blockage for the month of December 2018? Blockage for Scorpio. Quest. So some of you are definitely so this is a blockage. Quest, when it comes to quest as a blockage, you want to go out look for something. Now you might be seeking this thing for a very long time, but in the month of December I am feeling that you need to take rest. You are trying to seek something for a very long time, but now you need to take a rest. And let's see what else is here. Isolation. You need to take rest from isolation and stop your quest in the month of December and start mingling with other people. That's why I think I got this card, where probably you will find something, someone who loves you, likes you, and will offer you something. But I think you are probably sitting at home and you don't want to meet people, and that's coming up as a blockage. So give yourself a like, go out and don't sit alone. It's not going to help. And also work on your throat chakra, like heal your throat chakra. So there are throat chakra healing meditation on YouTube that you can listen to. Listen to it for at least a week, or there are guided meditation that you can do for throat chakra. So basically it's about speaking your truth. If you haven't been speaking your truth, or you are speaking something and you don't mean it, and then that's blocking your throat chakra. Receiving. So get ready to receive in the month of December. Be open to receive. Be open to receive things. Do not deny. Like I said, you will be offered something, but you will probably deny it because you feel you want more. Or if somebody rejects you, then receive that rejection, because rejections are like badge of honor. Receive that rejection and learn something from it, and move on. Don't stay stuck like, I offered this person my love and they rejected me. So what? move on, offer it to the next person who is probably worth it, and who, I know people get stuck on one person because they feel like they were the perfect one, but there is, I believe there is no one perfect. Second, if you can find one person perfect, you will find 10 million more, because I don't know why, but I feel like that, like, it's you who, how you see the world, and that's how the world reflects back. And if you find something nice in one person and you started liking them for something, it's because you want that thing in yourself, and not because they are like that. You want to be like them, and that's what you like about them. You like few qualities, and I believe you wish you had them. So either develop those qualities in yourself, okay, I'll share one thing. So, okay, this is very personal, so I'm not gonna share. sorry, now is not the time to share that. But yeah, what I'm getting here is that you will find someone if you open your eyes to a new opportunity and don't stay stuck. We get stuck to one person because we find them familiar, and we find them, we are used to them, and we don't want to open up to new people, because especially being in Scorpio, we can be a little bit secretive and we find it hard to open up. So be ready to explore, yaar, and don't stop yourself. What is already with you? So what I'm getting here is that you have something that you can build upon. You have something that is waiting to be applied. So you have some knowledge which needs to be applied. You have something that it needs to be done. So do that thing, and focus on those things and multiply it. Don't sit with it. Don't procrastinate. So if you have somebody very loving, express your emotions. Because I think that's what throat chakra was about. If you feel for someone, let them know. Don't hold it back. And once you let them know, maybe they will accept you, maybe they will reject you. At least you will have an answer and you won't be living in a lie. Okay? So that was your reading, Scorpio. I'll see you again. I don't know if I'll be posting in the year 2019, because I'm not getting the kind of response that I want. And I am a student as well, so I have to focus elsewhere as well. So if I would have been getting a better response on YouTube, I'm not saying like on Scorpio video, just generally, I don't feel like I have a very nice equipment or anything. So unless I'm in a better place, I think I'll stop doing videos. But let's see, I'm not sure right now. Okay, take care.